It did not help that she was encased in a cave made out of mirrors. Wide-eyed, slightly surprised, she saw in the light every hollow. Each carved callouses into her skeleton of matches, and the pools of bruised sleeplessness beneath her eyes. She lay back and allowed the red wine. Oh, it was blood, wasn't it? No, clear crystalline water to cascade over her blue lips, the bridge of her nose, slow cheekbones like a tidal wave over a steady mountain range. The bathtub cocooned her in a glorious embrace, and she wondered, though impassively, why she was so wet. She considered asking the melancholy bathtub, why, Lord, are you crying? When her lips parted, she couldn't make a sound through oceans. Oh, well, she thought. Her eyelids swooped. Swooned, she saw nothing. The lights of cities blurred. Trees still, if only for an instant, so small you couldn't see it through a microscope. Plants breathed, confused. They lowered their gaze to her. They watched her closely as her blood flowed slow, then stopped. The mirrors called out to her, "Awake, darling," yet she heard nothing. It was quiet. The bathtub began to drain. She realized with the startled sleepy laugh of waking from a dream that her heart had gone still. She had become nothing. Foamy wave upon a current. When her ballerina toes touched the ocean floor, the mirrors, the trees, cities, planets all sighed. Forgot. Someone drowned herself in a bathtub. Who? I don't know. Some girl. Forgot, carried.